Good morning. This is Pastor Chad Bailey at the Slippery Rock Baptist Church in Slippery Rock, Pennsylvania, coming to you in another Morning Minute Meditation. Just yesterday, we began a subject called the theology of sleep. There is definitely a theology in the Bible that applies to the rest and the sleep of the believer. You'll remember yesterday we spoke from Psalm 3 and verse number 5, where David said, "I laid me down and slept. I awaked, for the Lord sustained me." We can add to that truth Psalm 4 and verse number 8 from the same psalmist, where David said, "I will both lay me down in peace and sleep, for thou, Lord, only makest me dwell in safety." David trusted God not only in the daytime hours of his life, but he also trusted God in the night when he was resting. There was safety, and David said there was peace. And by the way, that word peace means a lot more than just the absence of a conflict. David's testimony was there is an inner adequacy, there is an inner fullness, there is an inner joy that carries into the nighttime hours of my life that allows me to rest in God, to rest in the Lord. Absalom was on the trail of David when he wrote this. The armies of Israel that had been trained by David himself were now pursuing their own king in a coup, in an insurrection. Didn't bother David. David went to sleep at nighttime and he slept very well because he knew that even though the enemy was after him, the Lord was busy sustaining him even when he was resting. In Psalm 127 and verse number 2, David said, "It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for he giveth his beloved sleep." God has a will for you even when you are not awake. And that is that you get rest, and that is that you get sleep. And only God can give us the peace that carries us through the nighttime hours. If there's some problem, some trouble in your life that is taking your sleep from you, give it to God today. The Bible said, "This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." God bless you. We look forward to speaking to you again tomorrow on this same subject.